What's going on, folks? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Monday, the 17th of November, 2025. I got Derek sitting shotgun. We're on our way to our third service call of the day. New residential client, Long Beach. No heat emergency service call. According to House Call Pro, which is our dispatching, invoicing, payment receiving app, you know, the all-in-one CRM to modernize your business, because it is 2025. Housecallpro.com/Mikey Pipes. According to House Call Pro, the house was built in 1925. I'm going to guess that if it has not had a change of heating system yet, it's steam. What do you think, Derek? Yeah. All right. Way says we're about 12 minutes from our destination. Hopefully we'll be able to record some footage. And God willing, we will get them up and running. Are you ready? Let's go. Whip out the business card, the red carpet treatment. 6, right? Yeah. You look cold, ma'am.
A wee bit.
You got your jacket on, your hat on. Hey, come on.
Thank you.
All right, it's okay, puppy. I'm Mike, and this is Derek.
Hello.
Here's my card. I'll put it there.
Right on. Okay.
Lead the way. Now we wipe our... Ah, grab the door, quick. You got it. Oh, the door. We almost lost the door. I'm worried about the wind taking and breaking the door. This is the thermostat. This is the thermostat for the heat. 56. That's the thermostat, yes?
Yes.
Okay.
And there's also one upstairs.
Two zones of heat? Okay, we're going outside again, huh? Oh man, you like subjecting me to torture, don't you?
And it's so cold.
We're going in this little outhouse.
The smoke is outside.
Ow. Well, we've been here before, it looks like. Okay. Let there be light, and there was light. Well, STA 1. So, zone valve, first floor, no resistance. Second floor's got resistance. Let's just quickly open this and see. Nothing happened. All right. Deck, grab the tool bag. I always say a good technician is observant of their surroundings. Take a look at this flue pipe on top of the water heater. Home Depot special. Alright. Looks like someone installed this who didn't really give a shit, if you know what I mean. Disgusting people. You know, oh, it's in an outhouse, you know, so who cares, right? Wrong approach, folks. Take care in the craftsmanship of your work. All right, so STA-1, the boiler's in standby. This zone valve is actively calling. If I take the end switch together here. Let's see what happens. You know what? Let's see what happens here. Look what we have. Circulator's running. Okay. STA 17. STA 18. Damper is open.
STA 18. STA 18 is waiting for damper to open. The damper's already open there. Could be jammed up a little bit, but. Derek, let me get a needle nose. STA 4. Pre-purge. STA 6. Spark. STA 7. Flame proofing. STA 8. Running. Thank you very much. So STA 8. Boiler's running, and the only thing I did was bypass our end switch here on that zone valve. So this zone valve was actively calling with no resistance here and was not turning the boiler on because the end switch is jacked up. So let me get a flat screwdriver. I love these Honeywell four wire zone valves because they're very easy to replace. So I'm gonna take out the two screws, top left, top right, take the head out, and if you look, there's that little lever that's activated by the spring in the motor, and when that is clicked in, right, we have a bad zone valve. Look at that. See, she's spazzing out. Let's do another further test. Now that we know the boiler's running, let's end that call for heat. Boiler turned off. Let's put back our wire nuts. I'm missing a wire nut. Let's just get this on there. Okay, see, it's still spazzing out. So we're gonna push in that little button right there and see if anything happens with the boiler. Yep, so we just have a bad head on the zone valve. So while we work on that, let's give her some heat temporarily. To replace the zone valve here, just the head. Mm-hmm. But while we do that and talk to her about the price, boom, there's our end switch, and she will start getting some heat. So I've got a new Honeywell zone valve here, and what we're going to do to replace this is take the valve head off of the body, and we're not going to touch that lever, the manual hold open lever. We're going to keep that as is. You don't want to touch it. Make your life easier. Okay. Now, we're going to just wiggle that on there. And then, once it latches into place and it's seated right, you'll be able to tighten up. The screws on the left and right hand side. Okay, we're not going to touch that yet. Remember, the boiler is actively running right now. Let's cut back these leads, and the two that I have bypassed there or jumped together, that's our end switch. The two yellow wires which go to the orange and yellow on the inside of the valve is our power. I'm going to use some of these Wago lever connectors. I'm going to put one there, and another one right here. And now these, one there, and one there. If you look, now it's energized, and our zone valve is powered. Now I'm going to work on the end switch. Show these two. Let's just clean this up. And one there. And one there. So now our zone valve is wired. We'll get a little zip tie there and we're done. All right, zone valve is complete. And we are up and running. Hot water's leaving, hot water's coming back. This other zone valve here for the second floor. Let's turn on the thermostat there and make sure that it works and it's communicating properly. Okay, hi ma'am, where's your thermostat?
Right behind you.
Okay.
You see it, huh?
70.
Your dog? No, I thought you said you had it here. Yes, and then I clicked.
No. Set that for 70. All right, so that second floor zone valve is not cooperating or not communicating with the thermostat properly. She just wants me to set it to manual. So whenever the first floor is on, the second floor will get hot. And coming back is hot. There's a return. Here's another return. They're both coming back hot. Let's finish up this service call by using my thermal imaging camera to make sure all the heat output sources are working properly. All right. Nice and hot. Also nice and hot. And up here, also excellent. Okay.